Well, hello. Evening all. To all of you. Right, where shall we start? Well, it's Saturday evening, and it is nearly 8:30 p.m. in the evening on Saturday, the 30th of October, 2021, Anno Domini. That's the full description of what date is today. See, I was brought up from here. Let me see. I was brought up from about 4 years old, an Anglican, a Christian, and it's never done me too bad. In fact, I've always followed the 23rd Psalm, and it's not done me bad at all, because I really believe in the 23rd Psalm. You know, I like to think that I'm more of a teacher than a preacher. If I had my time all over again, I'd love to be a headmaster. In fact, my old headmaster, Mr. Atfield, at Barnwell Secondary Modern in Stevenage, Hertfordshire, the rumour had it, and it was very true, that he was an ex-commando in the Second World War, and he was a prisoner of war. Well, he was a fantastic headmaster. He was very firm, but very kind. And I think that was a reflection on his life travels and as a soldier during the war. It must have been very, very difficult, but he was a smashing fella. In fact, he was like a bit of a dad to me, a bit of a second dad, because, you know, things happen, and my mum and dad parted when I was 11 years old. So, you know, my mum carried on bringing me up, and I was a bit of a, I was a bit of a tear away at times for my old mum. And there was one occasion when Mr. Atfield, headmaster, I'd had a row with my mum in the morning, and she was a manageress, had an important job in catering in the factories in Stevenage. And she had all her paperwork and books and things in her work bag, and I hid it, because I was a horrible little thing. I hid it under the larder. So I then hid upstairs, and I could hear her on the phone to Mr. Atfield. Well, Mr. Atfield came out. By then, I'd hidden in the loft, and I could hear Mr. Atfield came to our door, and I was in the loft in the corner. There was no lights there, so I wonder I didn't fall through the ceiling. Anyway, next thing I know, I could hear my mum saying, "I think he's in the loft, Mr. Atfield." And so she'd got a chair. There was no loft ladder, and all I saw was my headmaster's head pop through the loft hatch. But I was right in the corner. Silly man, he didn't have a torch. If he had a torch, he'd have caught me red-handed. Anyway, he went off back to the school, and I came out of the loft, and cut a long story short, I apologised to my mum. I said, "Oh, I'm sorry about this, mum. We was always ding-donging, you know." And, yes, and looking back, it wasn't a nice thing to do. I was a real handful. In fact, at one point, when I was 14, I played up so much, and I was getting drunk on cider. And in the summer holidays, when I was 14, in 1967, the summer of love and flower power and all that, and I worked for a lot of the summer as an ice cream boy on a ice cream wagon. And that time, for a long, long story, but I was getting bullied pretty bad. And but got over it, you know. It was just one of those things that a lot of us go through as young lads, you know. So sometime in our lives, I guess. Often it's just jealousy or whatever. In fact, it all started because I burnt a hole. We were sunbathing, me and my mates, And my best mates, well, I thought they were my best mates. And I burnt a hole with my cigarette in one of their T-shirts, and they took, they got right shirty. Next thing I know, they all ganged up on me, and they were bullying me. It was horrible. Oh, it was horrible. Anyway, I got through that. You do, don't you? Now I'm doing a bloody Ronnie Corbett, because I go round the houses and forget why. I would like to be a headmaster myself, just like Mr. Atfield. A smashing fellow used to wear the old cap and gown in assembly when we used to sing the hymns. In fact, I remember his favourite hymn. What was it? Oh, da 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 da. Forgive our foolish ways, dear Lord and Father of mankind. That was it. And every time I sing or I hear that hymn, a few tears come out of my eyes. Anyway, you'll be wondering where I'm going with this. Well, I'm going to sing you a song. It's Saturday night. I'm not so keen on Saturday night at the movies or sitting in the back row. Saturday's night's all right for fighting, honey. Was that Elton John? I don't know. Now, I'm going to sing you a real upbeat song. Unfortunately, the backing isn't brilliant, but I'll make it brilliant. Huh? And it is, wait for it, When This Old World Starts Getting You Down. Yes, it's Up on the Roof by the Drifters. The Tambler Motel, what a group, eh? I saw them twice live in Stevenage, where I was born, and not born and bred, but where I grew up from a tender young age. And I saw them once when I lived in my dad in Ramsgate. I saw the Drifters live in Margate, I think it was. Way back. Yes, in the early 70s, I think. Anyway, I've lost the thread a bit there, a little bit, because there was something important I was going to say there, and I've forgotten it. If I remember it while I'm singing the song, then when I was 14, I was such a... getting drunk on cider, and I was a right lad. And I went out and I bought some of these army boots from the army surplus store, and some jeans and a check shirt. I thought I was the kiddie. And I'd been a bit of a lad with a bit of petty crime, I suppose, a bit like the comic everybody loved him. He was like the lovable rogue, Charlie Peace, in the Beano. Used to get it every Sunday. And here me going, rambling on and on. No, the punchline is, I got sent away to a remand home, which was, tell the truth, just like a blooming borstal. Short, sharp shock, and it was in a place called Occident House in near Leighton Buzzard in Bedfordshire, not terribly far from Stevenage in Hertfordshire. But I remember the two policemen took me over in this maroon Austin Cambridge car, and they were ever so kind to me. We stopped off for sweets and all that, but when I got there, it was this old like mansion, and all the floors were polished. And when I got there, we all had to wear jeans and grey shirts. On a Sunday to go to church, we used to have to wear a black blazer. And it was, I was pretty hard. And it was autumn time, because I remember we used to sweep the leaves around this old manor house. And the man who owned it, a horrible man who smoked cigars, used to get me in his office and, used to leather me at 14. He'd tell me I'm no good and all that. He was horrible. But I finished up. I did 2 weeks and I had to go back to court because I was on remand. And I had a word with the judge. I said, look, I've learnt me lesson after 2 weeks. I just want to go home and live with my mum and my brother and sister. So the judge said, I'll tell you what I'll do. I can't let you go home this week, but I'm going to, instead of coming in 2 weeks, you can come back in a week. And if I'm satisfied that you've learnt your lesson, you can go home. Well, actually, he let me home after 20 days. But it was 20 days of bloody hell for a young man, you know. And my mum used to come and see me and smuggle me cigarettes in. 10 number 6 and a box of matches. And I used to smoke them at night in the dormitory. In the middle of the night when there was nobody there. Anyway, let's get on with the song, okay? Now, me backing, I've got to get me backing sorted. It's the light's gone out on me backing. Let's have a go. So, yeah, I've never done such a long introduction. It's 10 minutes, isn't it? Oh, yeah. Here we go. So, a one, a two, a one, two, three, four. Here we go. Yes. Boom, 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 on the roof, aye. When this old world starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face, I climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space. On the roof it's peaceful as can be, and there below the world can't bother me. Let me tell you now, when I come home feeling tired and beat, I go up where the air is fresh and sweet. I get away from the hustling crowd and all that rat race noise down in the street. On the roof, the only place I know, where you just have to wish to make it so. Let's go up on the roof. Boom, 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 boom. At night those stars put on a show for free, and darling, you can share it all with me. I keep on telling you, right smack dab in the middle of town, I found a paradise that's trouble-free. And if this world starts getting you down, there's room enough for two up on the roof. Up on the roof. Yeah, come on, baby. Well, come on, honey. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, I'll give it a good crack. Yep. And good fellow. And it's just, you know, the time is, let me see. It's only 20 to 10, so I won't disturb the neighbours. So, we'll say au revoir and thanks for listening to my going round the houses, like little Ronnie, and listening to my song. I wish you all of you, my friends, on Facebook, I wish you all the best for the future, because none of us know the future, and who knows in a few, some years to come, or, you know, generations to come, they might look at this video and say, what a nutter. I've lost my blooming eye, innit? Yeah, say, what a nutter. Did people like that really exist in the 21st century? Oh, yes, they did. Well, anyway, enough's enough. 14, nearly, I'll tell you what, countdown to 15. I'll finish on 15 minutes. We've got 12 minutes to go. So I'm going to say, God bless you, mwah, to the lot of you. And you're all special, the lot of you. Here we go.